As of December 5th, 2021, there are 53 volcanoes which are actively erupting. These include volcanoes such as Semisopochnoi in Alaska, which is the longest still ongoing eruption of the four separate volcanoes which are erupting in the United States. Another erupting volcano is San Cristobal in Nicaragua. With this being said, here are a few of this week's major volcano-related news stories. In the Reykjanes Peninsula of Iceland, a broad area of uplift suggests the intrusion of magma in the crust, which could lead to another eventual eruption. Also, in several different countries, four new volcanic eruptions began, including a rather unexpected source, Mount Pinatubo. Mount Pinatubo, after experiencing just slightly above normal levels of background volcanic activity, produced a dramatic phreatic eruption on November 30th. This eruption ejected a steam-rich white plume high into the atmosphere, reaching a height of 14,300 meters or 44,000 feet. This eruption was photographed by Philippine AirAsia Captain Aljess, Lasmarias, who snapped some pictures from the cockpit. Since this small 4-minute-long eruption occurred, which likely had a volcanic explosivity index rating of a 1, no additional activity has taken place. So, why was this eruption such a surprise? After Pinatubo's caldera-forming eruption in 1991, it has only erupted twice, each time producing small eruptions in the recently formed caldera lake. These two small eruptions were both preceded by an increase in volcanic gas emissions and earthquake activity. Yet, in the case of its eruption a few days ago, none of these warning signs are present. Phreatic eruptions can sometimes be near impossible to predict, as all you need for one to occur is groundwater and an underground magma chamber. With very little warning, this magma can cause groundwater above it to flash to steam, reach a critical point, and explode. Science has yet to figure out a reliable way to predict this style of eruption, which has led to deadly phreatic eruptions such as Mount Antake in 2014 and White Island in 2019. Thankfully, no one was harmed by this eruption from Pinatubo. In Indonesia, a new eruption began at the Iliwerung volcano, which is located in eastern Indonesia on the island of Lembata. This volcano contains a number of explosion craters, lava domes, and vents which are aligned along a northwest trending area of activity. Since 1973, all of its recent eruptions have originated from the Hobol submarine vent just offshore of the island. What made this most recent eruption quite interesting is that it originated from a completely different vent 1.5 kilometers to the south on November 28th. This created a 100-meter-tall plume which rose from the ocean, after which eruptive activity quickly declined. In Japan, the island of Iwo Jima produced a small phreatic eruption on November 25th. This eruption occurred on the beach adjacent to the northern tip of the island, thus blasting two craters in the sand and causing mud to flow from them. In Papua New Guinea, the dangerous decade volcano known as Uluwun was just raised to an alert status of orange. This change was made after an increase in earthquakes, steam emissions, and a small eruption which ejected ash on November 29th. In Iceland, the eruption of Geldingadalir amazed the world as it peacefully erupted for a period of 183 days, attracting hundreds of thousands of people to visit and even more to view it online. This eruption ended on September 18th, but it does not necessarily mean that eruptive activity is done in the overall peninsula. In recent weeks, a wide swath of land ranging from Kailir to the southern shoreline of the Reykjanes Peninsula has been uplifted by 2 centimeters. This is occurring as the volume of molten rock is intruding deep into the crust, thus building a large volume magma chamber at a depth of around 15 kilometers. The magma contained in this deep area is likely to intrude shallower into the crust a number of times, a few of which are likely to create eventual volcanic eruptions. Scientists early on in the eruption suggested that Geldingadalir was simply the first of several eruptions to be expected on the peninsula in the next several decades, and this is further proof. Thus, a similar fissure eruption is likely in the general vicinity at some point in the next 1 to 2 decades. Here's a quick list of every volcano which is currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes at raised alert statuses which are not erupting but could erupt relatively soon. I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new patron, Darren Lynch, for supporting this channel.